Hi all, in this video I will show you what is security in Genesis and how we can handle it. And one of the most popular issues with security we can check today, it's the case when you lost access to your Genesis server, for example like this one, and what we can do in this situation. So in this case you can do just go to Genesis home and configure config.xml file or configuration and delete security access. In this case you need to change your security setting to false and then remove two sections in this config file, and after that you need to restart Genesis server. So let's do it. We have our Google Cloud platform and our Genesis. Let's connect to SSH and edit this config file. Okay, we are on the server. Let's go to our Genesis home folder. This path you can find in the video about installing Genesis. Let's go with it, and here we have a config.xml file. Let's open it. So here we see that this use security we set it to false, and authorization strategy and security real arm will delete. Okay, everything is deleted. Let's save it. Okay, let's check again. Yes, everything is fine. Also, so let's reload our server. So server is reloaded. Let's check it. Here's our Genesis and let's reload our page. We need to wait for a while. And here server is reloaded and we see that we are not logged in, but we have access to the whole Genesis jobs and Genesis at all. So let's manage Genesis and check over here. It shows that Genesis is currently unsecured, so everyone can do anything, and we need to change security. Let's go to config global security, and here we should enable security and then check. We can delegate a serverless container, but we haven't it. We can use Genesis' own user database, and there is option to allow users to sign up. It's great, we will check it, because if we share Genesis access to our team and they have no accounts, they can sign up to Genesis, and then when the whole team will be registered, we can remove this checkbox and use it as a signed up team. Also this authorization that anyone can do anything. Okay, and let's save it right now and check it. Here we see that there are two new options, login and sign up, and let's try to create new account. We'll call it J. And some password, doesn't matter. Create account. And here we see that is a new user J. We can log out. And this user has access to all jobs and it can delete, it configure, everything works fine. We'll go to manage Genesis and configure our global security again. Right now we can remove this checkbox because let's imagine that everyone already signed up, and that's all. We don't need more registration, and we will change authorization to logged in. Users can do anything, and for anonymous they can just read. Let's save it and let's open in new anonymous tab and check how it looks. Okay, it's J here, but let's log out. So for logged out user we see login button, but it can't it's impossible to sign up for a user, and user can see all jobs, but he or she can't edit it or delete, just read only access. It's what we expected. Okay, what interesting else we can check here. Let's open again configure global security. Oops, because we are not logged in. Let's log in. And here we have matrix-based security, interesting option. We can create a user or group and provide access directly to this group with some specific credentials. Let's create group dev, it will be developers. Let's create managers and QA. And here we have options. We can allow for dev, we can allow everything. Let's create again managers. for QA everything, but for managers we can just read and view something and save it. It means that okay, we need to log in with another user, with admin. Okay, interesting case, let's open our config file. And here we see that we have authorization strategy. Let's use security set false and we'll delete this section of. Okay, we remove it and let's save it. Again, reload our Jenkins. So Jenkins reloading, let's wait. And here we again have access to our Jenkins. I just configure it a bit and return our all security configuration. Let's hit enable it and login users can do anything. Okay, let's save it. And here we see that we need login. Let's login with our usual password and here it is. Everything works fine. Thank you. That's it.